This is NITV News with Natalie Armour.
Good evening. Remote Aboriginal communities in South Australia are holding an emergency summit this weekend in a bid to stop funding cuts that could force the closure of communities in a move labelled cultural genocide. Representatives from every regional and remote community are uniting to call for long-term bilateral agreement between federal and state governments.
The closures sweeping Western Australia have South Australian communities fearful they'll be next, with municipal funding about to end and no grants for essential services secured under the Indigenous Advancement Strategy.
They've said, well, you can apply for IAS funding, which is Indigenous funding, to cover the gap. Communities went out and they applied for the funding, including ALT as the umbrella organisation. No communities in South Australia were funded.
Of the state's 30,000 Aboriginal citizens, about 10,000 live outside urban areas. Without money for services such as water, sewerage, rubbish collection and electricity, there are fears people will be pushed off their lands and into townships and cities.
We're going to end up with a new generation of displaced people, displaced Aboriginal South Australians, and this will be a new generation of cultural genocide.
The summit in Port Augusta will demand a bilateral funding guarantee from federal and state governments before the end of the financial year, just 12 weeks away.
It's somewhere between $6 and $7 million a year for the APY lands for these municipal services. We're hopeful that the federal government will continue to, as they have for the last half a century, fund these services.
They're saying they're not going to, though.
Well, we're in discussions with the federal government. It would be difficult for them to walk away from half a century of funding these things.
The communities want more than talk.
The refurbishment of places like Tandanyanga, Victoria Square, cost $30 million, or thereabouts. You know, we're wanting, you know, not much more than that to fund our Aboriginal communities across the state.
Communities concerned that the Prime Minister's lifestyle choices comment reflects an attitude of white privilege. Karen Ashford, NITV News.